We just learned a lot about the artist Roy Lichtenstein. He was born in 1923 and died in 1997, and his art is still very, very popular today. We are going to create a portrait in the style of Lichtenstein. A portrait is basically a picture of somebody. A self-portrait would be a picture of yourself. So if you have a mirror and you want to do a self-portrait, you can do that. I'm going to start off with a piece of paper. If you feel comfortable drawing with a pencil first, you can do that. But I am going to have you go over it afterwards with a marker or Sharpie if you're allowed to use those, because pop art usually has heavy, thick black outlines and primary colors on the inside. So we're going to start off with a very simplified portrait. So I was thinking of doing myself, but I'm not sure if I will. Let's see what it turns out like. I'm gonna go ahead and I'll start with, let's see, I think I'll do it in pencil first because I will do some erasing. I'll start with a head. I'm gonna do a little head shape. Can you see that pencil line there? Now, a lot of the times with pop art, your face doesn't have to look realistic. You don't have to put your eyes and your nose and your mouth. If you feel like you want to mix it up a little bit, like in the Lichtenstein painting Stepping Out that he created, you can mix it up if you want to. I'm going to go ahead and just make, to start off, a regular looking person. We've got a head, a neck, and some shoulders. I'll put my eyes right around this area. So it's pretty much in the middle of my circle. My eyes will go here, my nose will go here, my mouth will go here. So notice the measurements here. If you're trying to make a realistic looking portrait, the middle of your circle would be the eyes. The middle of the eyes and the chin would be the nose, and the middle of the nose and the chin would be the mouth. So if you're trying to have something realistic, you can do that. But again, like I said, if you want to mix up your shapes and everything, put an eye here, a mouth here, you can definitely do that too. We still want it to look like it's sort of like a person though. We want to keep that person look to it. We're just simplifying. We're using a dark outline to simplify areas and separate areas. We don't want to use too much detail. So generally, eyes have a lot of detail in them. We're not going to put a lot of detail. I'm just going to put a simple shape, maybe a little bit of a lid, not a whole bunch of eyelashes, maybe a couple. I'll put my iris in, my pupil, and then I'm gonna leave it. I'll go ahead and do another eye, and that's the hard part, is getting the same eye, getting one eye to look the same as the other. That's always a difficulty of mine. In pop art, don't worry about it. You don't have to do that. So one eye is definitely bigger than the other here. You have a little white spot in there. Yeah, can you see the eye difference? That's okay, it's pop art. We can mix it up and change it. All right, so I'm gonna bring my nose. The nose is generally in between the eyes. So I'm just gonna make a simple curve for my nose. If you have a different way of doing nose or a more simple way, you could even just do a nose like that if you wanted to. Whatever works for you, give yourself a simple nose. So we've got our eyes on our nose. I'll make a mouth, and I'm gonna simplify this mouth. Usually the upper lip is a little bit thinner than the lower lip. Now I can go ahead and add some detail. So let's go ahead and make some hair. I'll make a little bit of hair coming across here, and I'm just gonna go right ahead and do my marker here. So that way it's a little bit easier to see. Nice thick black outlines is what Roy Lichtenstein preferred to use. Go ahead and do an eyebrow up here too while I'm at it. And if they don't exactly look the same, that's fine. Like I said, it's pop art. Don't go crazy with the lashes. Sometimes it's fun, but we don't want to have too much detail. Remember, it is simplified. And I've got my mouth. I can erase some of these pencil lines later if I don't like them. Maybe a little hint of a smile there. All right, maybe some ear coming out. We'll have I'm gonna make this chin a little bit longer. I'm not happy with the size that I made it. So I'm gonna have it come down a little bit longer. This is why we use pencil first, because we can change it and erase. Yeah, I'll do this with the hair. Whatever hairstyle you want to do, you go for it. I'm just going to do something with little curls like that. Maybe I'll make an earring. Maybe I'll make a little flower in the hair. Simple flower. Bring down our neck shape. And again, super simple. Maybe I'll put a little shape in the background. So it's not just a head floating. It looks like we got something going on there. Maybe this is a mirror, maybe it's a picture. We'll figure it out later. But for now, we've got our portrait. It doesn't quite look like a pop portrait yet. If you chose to go ahead and mix up those shapes and faces, then it'll look like a pop portrait. But if you didn't, it won't quite look like a pop portrait yet until we add the color. So next time we'll add the color together, and I'll see you then for making our portrait into a pop portrait. Have prepared with you primary colors. We need red, yellow, and blue. And that's all we're gonna use for this, because that is what Roy Lichtenstein used. I will see you then. Bye-bye.